G'day and welcome to my garage.
I did a clean up of this face and the nuts some time back, but since then I've played with the stacking of the bearings and the shoulder distance of the nuts, so this is all changed. I've done some machining on it. I've done some machining on it and have found that that seventh out goes in there, tight to there, can't go in there. So this is five there. 1, 2, 3, 4. I can't get them in here for some reason. It's like it's on a slight tilt. I can on that one. That was 5 there. So we'll average out to 5 there. I will take these off and skim the nuts again. About another 2 there. Maybe 3 and see what happens. Before I can machine these nuts, they need to be held in place because that's loose. And there was a provision in the design for set screws to come in from the back. To run up against the back of those nuts. Now you don't over tighten them, don't wrench down on them. You're not tightening a cylinder head, just tight with a couple of fingers on the short leg. It's enough. You don't want to screw down too hard because it could twist the plate. So that will give me now a surface to machine. Lock the carriage in place and advance the tool. That's 34 on this. I'll take it up 2 and we'll see what happens. So I want 36. Put it in gear. I need to see something. Got a lot of weight in it. There's my stage. That was enough to make a mess if it looks like it. Number 3. Alright. Little bit of movement there, and that's what we're after. That's quite good. a bit tight up the outside here, but I just need to put, say, a 4th-hour shim underneath the bearing block. It's only really the last 2 or 3 turns where it's a problem. Alright, I'll check the others. I am currently machining the inside of this outer jaw. The reverse side, I suppose you could say. I've already faced that land off. Now I'm on the last legs of I'm getting to the last legs of this internal cut. A little bit further. Alright, looks like we can do 15. 15th hour cut. Still got number 3 jaw here. I've got them marked. That's still got a hollow in it from where I machined it earlier on the faceplate. So I've still got to go more. Try another 10. I will persist with this.
Alright, I'm doing the lower land, machining that off. It's getting there. It's getting there. And now for the final lick on the inside, on the innermost part. I'm just touching the the front plate there, but that's okay. I'll undercut that slightly. Remove the wrong control. No, well, I just have to take it as it is. Right. There we go. We're not finished. I've now got to do the 45s. Although the front part of this jaw ended up being a lot wider than I expected, through my mistake of turning the wrong wheel. It just means that the 45s will have to come back further to make the nose narrower. That's all right, I'll have to live with that, won't I? All right, next operation is to do the outsides. I haven't done those yet. Just machining the inside of the jaws now. Won't show too much because I've got to get my head in there. I think that will do. Now I can cut the 45s there and there. I'll work out whether I'm going to use the face plate with an angle plate to do that or put it on the mill. I don't know yet. I'll sort that one out. You'll find out in a second. That'll be the next set of clips. Just finishing off the first set of jaws. We're on the last stretch. So it's looking pretty good. It's only just sitting in there loose. It's just a guide. I made all the jaws cast all the jaws a little bit bigger than they should be, so I could have stuff to machine off, and that's pretty close the size there. I know this is a pretty sketchy setup, but it does work. I just have to be careful. Too hard. That's got 45. Jaw one is my template. You can see I've got the scribe marks there. I suppose Mr. Pete would be proud using scribe marks, working to the line. Get it very close to the number one jaw. It doesn't have to be exactly the same, and I don't want to take off more metal from number one. Hence why my big head's in the way. Just a couple of thou. Okay, I've flipped them around. I'm doing the other side, the other end now. Just put that up there. Hang on. That one.
Get that out of the way. Alright, I've got the sides to do now. Just square that up. If that looks good. And that's got that. Beautiful. And then the same on the other side. And then times four for everything, of course, but I've done some of them already. I'm just doing the final cleanup of these jaws on the four jaw chuck. I'm just machining the inside of the jaws at the present moment. So let's clean this up. Just contacting that one. That one's good. That one's good. That one's good. Now these jaws are brought all the way out and just nipped up. So I've increased it another 5 thou. Let's see what happens. That's good, that's good, that's good. It's
still a bit more to go on that one. Another 5. Good. That's pretty good now. That's good. Okay, I'll try that.
Well, that's a part I couldn't hold before in the three jaw chuck, but I can now. If I was to bore that 45 mil bore out before, I would have had to set it up on the faceplate. That's a 108.
That's 108 and 44, nearly 45 centre.
Beautiful. That works nice, I like it.
Now, I had to put a spacer in here because without that, the inner part of these reversed jaws come together. So I've only got about 3 mil clearance on those jaws in there now. So as you can see, that's a 12 mil block, so they were never going to come all the way in. I couldn't reverse it. The part isn't over, or the part's too wide, or it isn't over. Okay, one little job left to do before we're finished. Don't forget to take out the set screws that jammed the jaw nuts against the back of the front plate for when the jaw nuts were being machined. Don't leave them in there because they will move. One of mine did. Now don't forget, this is different to a Gingery mounting system because of the type of lathe I have. The chuck in itself is the Gingery four jaw chuck as presented in his book 6, the deluxe accessories. And that's it, the Gingery four jaw chuck is on the red one car. Of the beauties of this chuck, I suppose, I'll find out in time as I use it, is that these jaws can be moved around, reversed, put sideways if you wanted to, depending on the shape of the thing you're clamping. Excuse me. Also, what I think I might make is 4 round button jaws. 20 millimeters round, or the 25, they're 26, just round jaws, I might make those, but you can make whatever shape jaws that are necessary, and if you just nip them up, you can actually bump them around to the shape of the part that you're clamping. So there we go, the Gingery four jaw chuck is finished. Thanks for following my series.
And finally, where to store this thing, because you know it'll get lost.
In there.
The keys locked in place, ready for the next use. Catch you later.